I think you guys are really going to enjoy these verses. The subject matter is a little morbid. So let's start by looking at the ninth circle. Don't forget to do the reading. We'll pick this up on Monday.
Oh, hey, Cristina. Hey, how's it going?
Hey, Kyle.
Listen, are you in a rush to go anywhere right now? Because I wanted to know if you wanted to come with me to get that coffee.
I have a headache.
Oh.
Maybe Monday?
Yeah, Monday's good. I mean, yeah, it's fine. It's a day of the week. Monday. All right, I'll see you Monday.
Hey, Mom.
And I've tried...
Wait. No, retard. Your sister.
Oh, hey, sis. What's up? I can barely... Hello? I can barely hear you.
Wait, hold on. Hold on a second. Is that better?
Yeah, it's much better. What's up?
I hope you didn't think that I was going to let the fact that tomorrow's your 30th birthday go completely unnoticed.
Yeah, about that.
Stop! You are not going to sit in your apartment with Meiji old Missy like you usually do.
You don't know that. Maybe I need friends.
Oh, yeah, right. With who, huh? I'm the only person remotely close to your age that you even talk to. Since I know you're lame... Lame ass doesn't have any friends, I organize a little get-together with a few of my own. I am not going to take no for an answer, okay? You're going to have a good time if it kills you.
That's really not necessary.
That's really not necessary. Are you listening to yourself? Stop playing the old English maid and let loose for once in your life. I'm not going to take no for an answer.
Fine. Maybe I could make dinner.
Are you on drugs? Huh? Are you crazy? We are going out. Out, okay? You know, I'll call you later with buy something cute.
Situation of the ribs.
Bye, Olivia.
Here, where it gets up to your neck. And here's another piece of this other. Oh.
Mmm! Hey, you made it!
I thought you were back out at the last minute.
Well, at least now you can't say I never do anything.
Yeah, we'll see about that. These are my friends. That is Amber over there, Rachel, and Summer. Okay.
Whose apartment is this anyway?
It's a friend. I'm feeding her cat.
Listen, they go to school with me, okay, and they were kind enough to sacrifice their Saturday night to come hang out with you. So make sure you stay up past your geriatric bedtime, okay?
Noted.
There you go.
All right.
God, Cristina, are you really turning 30? You totally don't look old at all. When you walked in, I so thought you were our age.
Yeah, that's because she never wears makeup.
Sometimes.
Well, we should totally do a makeover right now.
That is a great idea. You look like you just got out of a parent-teacher conference. I'm serious, Cristina. I told you to wear something cute. I mean, this is just sad.
You know what? Take off your top, give it to her. I have a skirt you can wear.
What am I gonna wear?
I don't fucking care. Look at all this shit that you brought. Go pick something out. Okay?
Wait, tell me that you shaved your legs.
Okay, there's a razor by the sink. Go and take care of that. And when you're done, Amber will do your hair and makeup. Let's go. Oh, wait. Take these shoes because... Just take those shoes.
Okay, dude, seriously. Your sister is even lamer than I thought.
I think she's so sweet.
Is she gonna go for this?
I know she's weird. You know what? This is what we have to do, okay? Because once we start, she's just gonna fucking get up and leave, all right? Get her as fucked up as humanly possible. Okay, that is your mission for tonight.
Thanks, Amber.
Yeah. Don't mention it. So sweet.
I know. I'm out.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'll walk out with you, but.
Okay. Bye, Cristina.
I'm going home.
It was nice meeting you.
Yeah.
I think you should stay here tonight. Keys are on the dresser.
Oh, that's so sweet. Oh, wait, what about Missy?
Your cat is fine. Have fun for once in your life.
Oh, no. Oh.
It's just overnight, all right? Oh.
Wait, what about that guy in there?
You know what? He is all paid for. And he's off duty, so why don't you offer him a beer, huh?
God, I have a fucking boring headache. Hey! So you never told me how last night went.
Liv, you're never gonna believe what happened. Okay, so one minute we're sitting on the bed drinking beer, and I don't know who made the first move, but suddenly we're making out, and then all our clothes start coming off, and then before I know it, I'm having sex. Me, sex with this really hot guy.
I told you were gonna have a good time.
I mean, I can't even believe it. I never had sex before, and then this happens.
Wait, what? You, not even once?
I know. I don't know what I thought the big deal was. I mean, last night just seemed so natural.
That's good, I guess. Listen, Cristina, I didn't know. I assumed at least in college.
I invited him to come over later. I really like him. I know he's a dancer, but he's just doing that to get through law school, you know? Oh my gosh, I haven't even thought about what I'm gonna make for dinner yet. I can't believe he agreed to come over. Maybe I can get some of the steaks from the deep freezer downstairs or...
Are you sure you want to be alone in that house with him? I mean, you don't even know who this guy is. He could be some kind of psycho serial killer.
Ha ha, don't be ridiculous. Bobby is really very sensitive. We totally bonded last night.
Bobby?
Okay, I really gotta go now.
Just, Cristina, listen, just call me if something weird happens, okay?
Stop, I'll call you tomorrow.
This is not gonna end well.
Are you gonna eat this muffin or do you just want me to hold it? I'm hungry.
Can you stop staring at me? It's really creepy.
You know, I didn't used to like to drink before this weekend, but now I don't mind so much.
Yeah?
It's really nice having somebody over. I get so bored here with just my cat.
You got a pretty nice house here, huh?
After my father passed away, my mother moved down to Florida. And my sister lives in the city, but she doesn't like coming out here so much.
Tell me about it.
Would you like some dessert?
Sure, okay.
Okay, great.
I make this from scratch today.
Just wait till you taste this.
Yeah? Okay.
Don't worry about finishing it all. If we have leftovers, I can just bring them to my kids tomorrow.
No shit. You got kids.
No, Bobby. The kids I teach. Didn't I tell you last night that I was a high school teacher?
Yeah, that's right. It's cool, I guess.
So, what year in law school are you in? Do you know what law you're gonna practice already?
Wow. I'm so full. You mentioned the movie?
Oh yeah, I got that movie Forever Young. I'm a really big Mel Gibson fan.
All right, let's do it. Work for you, I can go with you to the ATM.
Why would I need an ATM?
So you got the cash? That's cool. Can you leave it on the table where I can see it?
What are you talking about?
The money.
What money?
You know, baby.
Is this a game or something?
You playing dumb? Because if that's a problem, I could leave.
Why are you getting mad?
Because it's either you got the money or you don't. You don't want to pay me?
Why would I pay you?
Really? Are you fucking stupid?
No.
To fuck you, you dumb bitch.
What?
What, to have sex with you? What? You think I came all the way over here to have fun with you? Your sister gave me $500 yesterday before she left. I bet you your fat ass was rolling off. You still were terrible late. Took me forever to get here. I could be dancing right now, but instead I was here all evening listening to your fucking ass talking my ear off about stupid shit. Give me my fucking $800 for this pathetic house call. Shit, man, I need this money. Oh, I knew this was a bad idea.
You don't have to live like this to pay for law school.
I don't go to law school, you pathetic cow.
Bobby.
What? What?
Last night was my first time. I thought you liked me. I invited you here because I wanted to get to know you better.
Know you better? Look at you, you're pathetic. I didn't even tell no one I was coming down here because I was fucking embarrassed. I had to sleep with you to pay my debts.
Stop yelling.
Newsflash, Bobby is not my fucking name. God!
I don't believe you. Olivia would never do something like this.
Believe it. Call her. Ask her. We were laughing about it all night. She's just doesn't know what to do with you. Doesn't. And I bet you she's laughing right now with her and her slutty friend.
I think it's time for you to leave.
I can't wait to fucking leave, but I'm not going nowhere till you pay me for this mess. The multicolored moods of love are like its satin waves. Love makes your heart feel strange inside. It flutters like soft wings and fly. Love is like a butterfly, a rare and gentle thing. Your laughter brings me sunshine. Shit. Probably wasn't worth anything anyway.
Look at this mess.
What the fuck is that? That's not even enough. That's not even enough for fucking mercy fuck. Christ, you're fucking useless. Daffodils and butterflies. Love is like a butterfly, as soft and gentle as a sigh. The multicolored moods of love are like its satin wings. Makes your heart feel strange inside. It flutters like soft wings and fly. Love is like a butterfly, a rare and gentle thing. Love is like a butterfly, a rare and gentle.
Here's your money, you rude motherfucker.
We're gonna make buff bourguignon, beef stew, and red wine. And it's a wonderful show to begin our series on because it showed you so many useful things about French cooking. How to brown meat, how to braise onions, how to saute mushrooms, how to make a wonderful sauce, getting ready for this program. And I've tried several different cuts, some from the leg called the top round and the bottom round. And from all the stews I've made, I find that I like chuck the best. So these are various pieces of chuck. This is called the chuck tender, and it comes from the shoulder blade up here. And it makes an awfully nice stew because the meat doesn't get springy. And this is called the undercut of the chuck, where it's like the continuation of the ribs along here where it gets up to your neck. And here's another piece of it. This is called flunkin meat. And that's awfully good. That's sort of from the short part of the ribs of the chuck. And you cut up the meat into pieces about like that. We're going to serve this for 6 people. So we want to have 3 pounds of meat. I usually count on 1 pound of boneless meat for 2 to 3 people, but if you have a good appetite, you want to have a little more than that. And then if you can make this stew way ahead of time, anything that's left over is extremely good. Now we want to get our pan hot, and we're going to saute it in this first until it's brown, and then we're going to put it in this pot into which we're going to cook it in the oven. Before you saute anything, you want to make sure that you have it good and dry. So I just take a whole lot of paper towel like that and just dry the meat off. If you don't have the meat dry, you can't brown it because it's as though it was steaming. There's water on the bottom of the meat and it just drops. It can't be smoking and burning, but it just has to be hot enough because if the pan gets crowded, then the meat.
Cristina, hey, how's it going? Were you sick?
Yeah, I had pretty bad food poisoning on Monday. Oh. It's pretty rough.
Yeah, because I've had that before like once or twice. It's not fun. how are you feeling now?
Pretty good, can't complain.
Okay. Yeah, that was quite an assembly we had, huh?
It was pretty fucking boring if you ask me.
Yeah, I guess it was a little boring. So, how was your weekend?
It was fun. It was my birthday on Saturday.
Wow, really? Wow, happy birthday. Did you celebrate?
Yeah, I went into the city with my sister and some of her friends. It was no big deal.
Oh, glad to hear it was fun. So how did your classes go?
Same old.
Do you have Jason Conley? I swear, that kid is getting more and more out of hand.
He's a real piece of shit, that one.
I don't know if I would know that.
You know, I just recently figured out they have to put them in their place, you know? They gotta learn sooner or later who's boss, I mean. Hey, what are you doing this afternoon?
Nothing. I was just gonna go home and relax a little bit.
Do you still wanna go get that coffee?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, let's go.
All right.
You have to try this meatloaf.
You gotta be kidding me. I'm so stuffed already.
I got up real early to prepare this meal. Please? Don't you want to make me happy?
Fine, yes.
I have to tell myself. You never told me you were such a really good cook, by the way.
Thank you, Kyle.
You're welcome.
Lucky for you, none of us is vegetarian. There's like 2 whole cows on the table.
The steak was stellar, by the way.
Thank you again. I'm glad you liked it.
I did.
You haven't eaten any of the food.
I was eating and cooking. I'll have some in a bit.
So, you never told us how the rest of last weekend went. I heard that you were expecting some company on Sunday.
Yeah, you know, I actually got stood up. I was kind of bummed, but I ended up getting really bad food poisoning on Sunday night, so I guess it was for the best.
Oh, well, bummer for you, I guess.
Try the meatballs, Amber.
Mm. I swear, Cristina, I'm like totally gonna turn bulimic after this dinner.
I don't know. We wouldn't want to waste perfectly good meat, that would we?
No.